We will not be bullied and intimidated by anyone to abandon these principles. We have heard from speakers yesterday and today about Rahaone's life. What stands out for me from what they have said and what I remember of him was his passion for farming, for politics and the BDP, for his family. We remember his laugh, we remember his humor, and of course, his devotion to this nation and its people. So if you were to ask yourself, between politics and farming, what do you think he liked the most? For the answer, I would refer you to this picture. Here, there's another picture over there. And I think from what we have heard today, that I think was something which was so close to him. He probably would like to have taken that statue of that beast into his bedroom with him. He felt so passionate about farming. That would have stopped people barging into his bedroom without knocking. Another example of what he was I received an email expressing condolences from someone overseas who I know well. And I quote, and he said, "Dear Ian," that's me, "last Friday I learned about the passing of Sir Kitumela Masire and send you hereby my condolences. As you may be aware, he was my boss for 2.5 years when I was in the Ministry of Finance Development Planning, and he the VP and Minister of Finance. He was a wonderful person to work for, highly motivated, focused, a person who loved his country. He also had a sense of humor. He appeared a modest man, as well as a wise and grassroots politician. He was a great partner to Sir Seretse, and the two made a formidable team in more ways than one." End of quote. But there was another partnership that I believe made a formidable team. And that was the partnership between Rahaone and Mahaone. And I was not able to speak at her funeral. I don't mean that I was prevented from speaking, no. But I just wanted to pay tribute to her because she was such a wonderful and lovely person. And she really reached and touched many people's hearts, not only those of the family. So to her, they have this saying that I don't necessarily subscribe to, that behind every successful man but I think in his case it was really relevant because Mahaone was certainly a pillar of strength, not only for Rahaone, but I believe even for the family. My fondest memories, I served under President Masire whilst I was in the BDF, the whole time he was president. My fondest memories with him was when I toured with him regularly as he was our Commander-in-Chief around BDF operational areas. There was one incident which I've been debating whether to remind Carter about, but although he wasn't there. At one of these bases, it was in the Okavango area, and you heard from President Mugabe that the Okavango is an area which has a lot of water. Some of our operations we conducted, the BDF conducted on horseback, because the water is so deep, vehicles cannot go through. So I'd taken him to one of our camps to show him where we kept the horses and the training we did with soldiers. And then as we were there looking at the horses and everything, this silly captain comes along and he says, "Would the president like to ride one of the horses?" And before President Masiri could answer, I said, no, he doesn't want to ride any horse. But knowing him as he was, he said, no, let me ride one of the horses. And I just thought, what am I going to tell Botswana if he falls off? So I said to the captain, find me the gentlest horse that won't misbehave so that he can get on it. And then find me the second gentlest horse so that I can ride that one. Because I've had a few experiences with falling off horses in my life. So that's what happened. He got on the horse, and what should happen, you all know. The horse misbehaved. The gentlest horse misbehaved, and it threw him off. But he bounced up and, you know, was okay with it. And that captain, the next day, was a civilian. I feel honored to have followed in the footsteps of these great leaders who have made Botswana what it is today and why we are proud to be Botswana. May his soul rest in peace, and may we continue to comfort and support the family with our prayers. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Excellency. So, Mr. Eno, you know how to maneuver when you get to the BDF. First thing you should do is ask for the gentlest horse, I get. We continue with the program. The family has requested a hymn here. Ikanya rarawa khahu, yaroma. I request that the choir, we do that song, and while we do it, Mayor Doreen Ramogala Masira Baipakanya to come and read the obituary along with Pilo Ame Modisane. Let's have the hymn Ikanya rarawa khahu. While they are here, BDF, get ready with your musical item. And after the sermon, clap and tap, you get ready to do your item.
It's an A.
Okay.
Dumelang baholo, dumelang batswana ko gae, ke tle go bala botshelo jwa ga rre. The late Sir Kitumile Masire, 23rd July 1925 to 22nd June 2017. During his over 6 decades of distinguished public service, the former President Kwet Kitumile Johnny Masire, NYB, GCMG, was the chief architect of Botswana's democratic development. As vice president and minister of finance and planning, as well as president, Sir Kitumile contributed immensely to Botswana's emergence from being ranked as one of the world's 10 least developed nations to middle income status. During the same period, Botswana also made enormous strides in the provision of education, health, and social welfare. Kwet Kitumile Johnny Masire was born in Kanye on the 23rd of July 1925 as the first child of Johnny Masire and Habaiponi, who was of the Kopo family. Like most of his male peers, he spent much of his early childhood as a head boy. At the age of 13, he was able to attend Rachele Primary School, where he displayed a remarkable academic aptitude. As one of the first local students to earn a government bursary, he was able to continue his studies in South Africa at Tiger Kloof Old Mueding Secondary School in 1944. In 1946, following the death of his parents, Kwet, as the firstborn, was confronted with the need to provide for his siblings. This development caused him to forfeit his opportunity to attend university on a further bursary. Instead, he acquired a teacher's certificate. In 1950, Masire became the first teacher as well as head teacher of the new Kanye Junior Secondary School, now Sepapizo Secondary School. In the early years, he taught 8 subjects: Setswana, English, History, Philosophy, Hygiene, Geography, Mathematics, General Science, and Music. In an interview he will later recall, "I wanted to teach. I wanted to communicate information to the people. So I worked as a teacher for 6 years. I enjoyed teaching everything because I was good at all, save for music, because I could not sing." Under Masire's initial guidance, the school grew steadily in terms of both students and staff, causing it to move to its present site. During this period, Masire was also active in wider community affairs, serving as the secretary of the Bangwaketse Teachers Association and chairman of the Bangwaketse School Sports Association. Masire's passion for teaching continued into his later life. In 1967, when he was already vice president and minister of finance, he helped found and taught night classes at the Capital Continuing Classes. While still working in education, Masire had maintained his lifelong passion for agriculture, often visiting the then government's experimental plots, as well as the then white-owned local commercial farms, to expose himself to new ideas. At the end of 1955, having saved enough money to buy his own tractor, he left the teaching service to become a full-time father. He would later recall that he had substituted one form of teaching for another. "I wanted to go and teach people innovative methods of farming. People were surprised that a person could leave a respectable profession such as teaching to do something ordinary and common as farming. His modern methods of cultivation were initially derided by some, but his big yields silenced the naysayers. In 1957, he became the first indigenous African in the Botswana Land Protectorate to be awarded a Master Farmer Certificate. Throughout the 1950s, Masire was regularly appointed or elected to various Bangwaketse Development Committees. On the 2nd of January 1958, Masire was wedded to Gladys Olibile Mogwera. Their marriage was subsequently blessed with their 6 children, 3 daughters, Khaone, their firstborn, Masekwa and Matsidiso, 3 sons, Mpo, Metla, and Moabi. During the same year, Masire began to acquire a national reputation as the Botswana editor of the Naledi ya Botswana Africa Echo newspaper. It was in this role that he became politically engaged and first met Seretse Khama. In 1961, Masire was elected to both the Reformed African Council and the Higher Legislative Council, being the only commoner from the Southern Protectorate to be elected to the latter body. Among Masire's notable Legislative Council contribution was his successful advocacy for the formation of the Botswana Meat Commission as a statutory corporation. I think I'll continue reading as my cousin here cannot see very well. Late in the 1961, Masire was approached by Seretse Khama and others to play the leading role in organizing what became the BDP. Drawing on his many newspaper educational contacts, Masire quickly established an organizational network that became the basis for the party's landslide 81% of the vote in 1965 general election. He also established and edited Terisanyo, a party periodical that appeared regularly from 1963 to 1967. From the beginning, the new political government was to a great extent a partnership between Seretse's vision and charisma and Masire's energy and organizational activity. As the nation's first Minister of Finance, later Finance and Development Planning, as well as Vice President, Masire championed a series of robust interventions to elevate Botswana out of its then prevailing status as one of the world's least developed countries, which in 1966 had an annual per capita income of only about $60. His development program included channeling foreign aid, loans, and mining revenues into the development of educational, health, power, transport, and communications infrastructure while encouraging small-scale services and industries. Efforts were also made towards promoting commercial agriculture. Important milestones championed by Masire's ministry between 1966 and 1980 included the establishment of the National Development Bank, Botswana Power Corporation, and Botswana Development Corporation, the introduction of the Pula as a local currency in place of the rand, and the favorable renegotiation of Botswana's share of revenues from the Southern African Customs Union. In the early years of independence, Masire's dynamic approach was unpopular with some conservative bureaucrats, while others resented his preeminent influence over national policy planning. But Seretse maintained his faith in his deputy. In 1969, Masire suffered a setback when he lost his Kanye parliamentary seat to Kgosi Bathong wa Bobedi, who had left Bogosi to lead the BNF. Thereafter, Masire retained the office of vice president as specially elected member of parliament until 1974, when he was elected in the Ngwagedzi West constituency. By the end of the 1970s, the success of Masire's development portfolio had gained him increasing international as well as domestic respect and political clout. Masire succeeded to the presidency in 1980 with the overwhelming support of his party's parliamentary caucus, presiding over the late Seretse's unfinished term until 1984, when he led his party to victory in his own right. By then, he had seen the country through severe drought and an early 1980 slump in diamond sales. Having previously played a leading role in the formation of Botswana as a 50-50 partnership between the government of Botswana and De Beers, as well as the formation of the Botswana Diamond Veiling Company, in 1982, Masire overcame objections to oversee the conversion of a portion of Botswana diamond stockpiles into a 15% stake in De Beers itself. Masire's tenure was thereafter characterized by continued high rates of economic growth and social development, marked by Botswana's rise to middle income status. Indeed, from 1966 to 1998, Botswana enjoyed the highest annual economic growth rate in the world. The resulting rising revenues allowed for further investment in infrastructure and public services, as well as human resource development, with education and health consistently taking the lion's share of the budget. Sir Kitumile's legacy goes beyond our borders, as during his time as both Vice President and President, he also played a key role as one of the leaders of the frontline states in the liberation of our region from colonialism and apartheid. In the early years of independence, Masire had been deputized by Khama to engage the exile leadership of the African National Congress and other liberation movements to establish a modus operandi for their discrete movement through Botswana. In response to the ANC's request to establish bases in the then newly independent Botswana, Masire presented the movement with an alternative that, if you can come through in a way that we cannot see you, then we will not have seen you. Masire would later observe that it was thus agreed that our official policy was that we did not allow the liberation movements to use Botswana as a springboard to launch military attacks on neighboring countries. If the ANC managed to infiltrate arms and guerrillas through Botswana, we would claim not to have seen them pass through our country. In 1980, Masire chaired the first meeting held in Arusha to form the Southern African Development Coordinating Conference, SADC, later called SADC, which succeeded in drafting the nascent organization's constitution. After leaving office, Seki Tumile divided his time between his passion for farming and frequent service as both a domestic and global statesman, often working through his Seki Tumile Masire Foundation. Internationally, he chaired the panel of eminent persons that investigated the 1994 Rwandan genocide, was the facilitator of the Inter-Congolese dialogue, and the SADC mediator for Lesotho and most recently Mozambique. And up to until the recent time, the time of his death, he remained a respected voice for peace and good governance on the African continent and beyond. Beyond his many contributions to this country and region, Rarahaone will be remembered for his character, his humility, wit, and decency, which personified the values of Botho. He always remained accessible and engaged with individuals from all walks of life. In this respect, while he has left us with a larger than life legacy, he was very much part of the lives of all Botswana. Lady Ulibile Masire passed away in May 2013. Seki Tumile Masire is survived by 4 siblings, 6 children, and 12 grandchildren. May his soul rest in eternal peace.
Thank you, Bokhaitsadi. We proceed with the program. Retlareza Pinaka BDF. That will be introducing the sermon, and straight after the hymn, if Moruti can come straight to the podium to the lectern to deliver your sermon. BDF, please.
Thank you. name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I greet all of us this morning. My name is Aaron. I'm standing here on the virtue of being the pastor of Sekitumile Masire for the past 2.5 years. Our sermon will be taken from the following books. First, we'll read from Psalm number 34, verse 18. Verse 18. Psalm 34, verse 18. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and he saves those whose spirits have been crushed. The second reading will be coming from 2 Corinthians chapter 1, and we'll be reading verse 3 and 4. Praise be to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is full of mercy and of all comfort. He comforts us every time when we have troubles, so that we can also comfort others with the same comfort God has given us. This is the word of the Lord. And I would like us to consider this word as our theme. That is in 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 3, which says, praise be to God. And I think maybe the multi-million question that may come into our minds is, how can we praise God while our hearts are stirred by grief? I would like us to consider the thoughts that are enshrined in the text that we have read so that they can help us to understand the reasons why we can praise God. First, our proof text, which is verse 3, says, praise be to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is full of mercy and who is full of comfort. But the psalmist says, this God that is full of mercy, that is full of comfort, he is close to those whose hearts are broken. And I want us to get it from this angle. You don't need to apply to him when your heart is broken. You don't need to make any request. By the virtue of him being the Father of all mercies, when your heart or my heart is broken, he decides on his own to associate himself with you. And as you are here and we are grieving, I want to tell you, God is here with us because our hearts are broken because of losing our Father. But if there can be any application